Hi everyone, it's Sailor Mimzy, and this week I have a flip through for you. Picking up where we left off last time when I was going through my old journals. So last time we left off, we finished going through book one of my exploded Mikhail Ryu's notebook. My first Mikhail Ryu's notebook. Here's book two of, I think it was made into four. So that Mikhail Ryu's notebook that exploded turned into five notebooks. So this is book two of that bunch. And I haven't flipped through this at all. I may have leafed through it, but I didn't read or look through it, so I wonder if there'll be any cringeworthy moments. So this is just scrapbook paper, and I made the label with stamps, and it's just a stamp there. Is October 28th, 2014 to November 28th, 2014. I didn't do that on purpose, it just worked out that way. So it's a couple days before Halloween. So there's just a mixture of stickers, tape, and drawings. And drawings are colored in with marker. So this cupcake is a sticker. I found really awesome set of like the photo realistic or whatever stickers that were Halloween themed that year, and they were the cutest, and I haven't been able to find them again since. So in here I'm talking about how I'm rewatching the old Sailor Moon series, and my favorite has always been Serena or Sailor Moon, but while rewatching it says here, I can't believe her whining and crying never got to me before. Oh, I still love her though. So the date stamp there is actually done with a circle stamp that I found in the dollar spot at Target back in the day when it was in Winnipeg. And the date stamp is just, yeah, a plain date stamp. And when I realized that it fit inside of the circle, it was like a whole new thing for me. It was so exciting. I don't know if I mentioned that in my last flip through of my old journals. Yeah, but then anyway, so the ghost is just a doodle there. And there is a quote here by the amazing Julia Child of Hardy without cake is just a meeting. That was awesome. Okay, so the other side is covered with scrapbook paper and there's movie stubs. Me and my husband went to go see John Wick. We like Keanu Reeves. And on this side, it is the next day. So there's just some stickers and doodles and tapes. And here I got a huge Studio Calico rubber stamp. So I wrote Sailor Mimzy there. And then this is part of those realistic or the photo Halloween sticker set. And so is the candy corns and the pumpkin. Oh, I'm just reading this. I'm just talking about the previous night, how we went on a date night. And we had time to kill before the movie, so we went for coffee. And we don't usually do that. But my husband read his book, and I drew in my sketchbook. And I had a cafe mocha and a birthday cake donut. He probably had the same, but with hot chocolate. And the next day, labels from testing these out. I should have tested them when I brought them. Yeah, I was testing out the makeup that my sister and I were going to use for Halloween. So this one apparently stained my skin. Glad I don't work tomorrow. My hands look really gross. I feel bad for the people that smeared this all over their faces. It was like the fake blood. And there's just, this is a magazine cutout. Stickers, doodles, more stickers and tape. Oh, and there's a bear. Cute. And here's just overflow writing about Halloween. This was Halloween Day. Do you people recognize these guys? And this magazine cutout and a sticker. Oh, what's this? Oh, this is when we went to Comic-Con. So these are different tickets to get into Comic-Con, parking stubs. We got temporary tattoos that I didn't use, so I just stuck them in my journal there. They're backwards. What do they say? Jason of New York City. Oh my gosh, I'm so excited. I'm like reliving Comic-Con right now. So on this side, I just overflow writing, obviously, because this side's all full. So I'm just writing about all the different costumes that I've seen and all the funny moments. And we took our nephews, so Yeah, we took lots of pictures. They had my one nephew, he had to pose with everybody that we've seen pretty much. It was so funny. And so there's some different fandoms here. There's Batman, my fave, and I tried drawing a TARDIS there from Doctor Who. There's a reboot button. I don't know what this is. So I think someone gave me this card. And then we got the wristbands to get in. Oh, that was so much fun. Look, I don't care about bleed through. Oops, that's my phone. Yeah, so the outline of Batman and Robin appeared on this side. So there's a magazine cut out there. And then just some doodles and lots of writing. I went to go see my friend and her son this day. Oh my gosh, I just read this thing. I was like, why did I draw a broken egg? So, genius. Making myself a fancy breakfast this morning. Instead of my usual favorite Cheerios, I had toast and eggs. I don't know what happened, but I dropped the first egg on the counter. It cracked and also started to fall off of the counter. I don't know what I was thinking, but I tried to catch it with my hip so it wouldn't fall to the floor. So I've got egg all down my hip, leg, cupboard, and floor. Ruined the whole fancy breakfast feeling. Oh my gosh, I don't even remember doing that, but I'm glad I wrote it down. There's some spooky coffee crisp. So this is actually called coffee crisp. I think this is maybe just a Canada thing. But for Halloween, they changed it to like this flat black wrapper and they called it Coffin Crisp. There's some cute animal related stamps up there. And the bear. This is chopsticks wrapper. Free bag of vegan meat substitute thing. It wasn't scanning at the grocery store, so they let us have it for free. That's pretty awesome. So after the supervisor at the grocery store told the cashier to just give us the bag of stuff for free, my husband took the bag from the cashier and jokingly, like, he did this is all as a joke, but like he was doing it like he was serious, but he almost ran me over with the shopping cart and he was like, let's get out of here. He was pretending to panic and like take off with the free grocery item. These might look familiar to you guys. It's the page flags from the Target dollar spot. There's a cat cut out from a magazine. And some doodles. A bee stamp. And a note that I'm back to trying to read A Clash of Kings. Eventually, I did finish that book. So we're in November 5th, and the bunny heads are from a Miffy book, that same Miffy book that I mentioned before in one of my other videos where I show the paper bits that I use. And there's doodles of donuts, the sticker, and this is from the Target dollar spot as well. It has a quote, "If the moon smiled, she would resemble you." Some Alice in Wonderland stuff there. And these flowers are cut out from an envelope that was not usable. There's some washi, and I love making these little envelopes. What's in here? So one of these is a list of, because we were in charge of Christmas that year. So there was a list of all the food, snacks, and like the different entrees that we'd be serving. And the other bit of paper in here is a joke that a coworker sent me that I am not going to repeat. Oh. This is when I ordered, oh look, you can see bleed through. I don't care about it, obviously, in here. Ugh, that's bugging me, but can't do anything about it. It adds character, we'll say that. So this is when I first ordered from Kiki K. So I kept all the packaging because it was so pretty. And it was the gold planner that I grabbed. It was November, so I drew a little doodle of myself with a mustache. And this is the Super Mario Brothers mustache, well, Mario's mustache. And some more doodles and stickers and tape. Oh, can't turn the page. So here I have lots of writing, more packaging from the Kiki K. And this is a note that I found at work in a book. Use lyrics from Dragon Ball, or quotes from Dragon Ball. And then here I just did some drawings. I had a headache this day. And this day my husband and I went to a social, which is a Winnipeg thing, I'm sure. But it was a wedding social, so it was basically like a huge party, and it's to raise money for people getting married. They're the ones who have the social. I don't know how else to explain it, but yeah, so it's, yeah, just a huge party for them to raise money. Lots of fun. Paper bits, decorating with washi. And this little note here was cut out from, I have like a scrap paper pad, so it's cut out from that. Chocolate mint ice cream cones for dessert. And my husband dropped his scoop on the floor. And I was sick this day. Oh, look, I got a new, I got a new date stamp. Oh, this day it was Sadie's birthday. So there's just different cutouts here from magazines, that Miffy book, post-it note, and I did a drawing of the special treats that we got her from the pet store. And here I write down that it's currently snowing so perfectly outside. Big, fat, slow, fluffy flakes. There's Sadie. Sadie has a pig. And here I was just probably covering up the other side, but just scrap paper with a quote. My ambition was to live like music. The paint on the polka dots came off, so I had to fill in the blanks with marker. And then just some painting and doodling here. This is when I first discovered gingerbread tea. I think it's by Celestial Season. Wait. Celestial Seasonings? I forget the name brand, but I hoarded a whole bunch this past winter because it's just a seasonal tea. But I think I still have like 5 or 6 boxes. That's when it all started. There's a cutout of cartoon Star Wars. These are from that Miffy book that I keep mentioning. So I just use a circle punch to cut those up. This is from an advertisement for those shortbreads. I don't really like shortbread. My husband loves shortbread though. And in here I drew a beet. And it says here, I could watch seasons of The Office over and over and over. Even if it makes me cringe. I heart Michael Scott. And there's just some stamps cut out there. Stairs. And this is washi tape. Ooh, this is when we went on a day date to the museum because there was a pirates exhibit. I brought my sketchbook with me, so I think I used up like 5 or 6 pages drawing the different things that we saw that day. some more doodles, watercolor, and a big cutout of a kitten head. Every time I draw a nutcracker, it looks terrifying. I love nutcrackers. I'm talking about school stuff and work stuff. On the other side, there is a pizza memo, piece of memo paper. It says, I don't do anything with my life except romanticize and decay with indecision. That's a quote from Allen Ginsberg. So these are my super fast doodles. Sadie looks terrifying. So there's Sadie in her dog form. And then Sadie in her pig form. I think I was trying to demonstrate something. I forget what. But yeah, it was like a minute doodle. And then here, wow. A huge magazine cutout and a little bit of writing up top. Oh, it was busy. We were doing, well, I was planning for Christmas and stuff, so I didn't have a whole lot of time to journal. But I wrote down here, relax. And then if you look at the picture, there's a girl there. I think she looks relaxed. Maybe that's why I used that cutout. There was tons of snow and lots to shovel. And there's more stickers and a doodle of a creepy bear that I did there. Some Animal Crossing. This was my 100th page. Oh yeah, I was numbering these pages too. So I would number a few pages at a time. And I drew this little clothing line with random things hanging from it. This is a cutout from, I think, a brochure? I'm not sure. And on this day, we saw Big Hero 6 in theaters. So I drew Baymax there. And I kept the ticket stubs. I stopped collecting ticket stubs, I think last year, just because they don't survive long. And it's not a huge deal for me to save them. Back in the day, I think a couple years ago, maybe 2014 or 2013, I finally got rid of ticket stubs that I had from the 90s. Because some of them were so faded you could barely read it. So it was just pointless. I've been trying to draw movie stubs. But now it's just, yeah, writing down the movie that we've seen and who I went with, the date, and where I went to go see it. So I think over time these will just be blank eventually. And just a little note there. Husband picked up a box of assorted goodies from Baraka. I forget what, I think it's Middle Eastern food over there. I don't remember. It was good. So there's a cutout here from Wizard of Oz book that was being recycled. The illustrations in it were weird and pretty. And here, currently in bed feeling sick. So that's that. Oh, my husband was making his famous soup that night. So I drew little vegetables. Wow, I could barely even notice where I put the date. So there, November 20th, 2014. It was our 4-year wedding anniversary. And, oh yeah, we kept it quiet that year. And there's just a note here from my coworker. And just cutouts from flyers and there's tape there from IKEA. It's getting Christmassy. Some doodles. And oh, it was a yellow theme. I think this Batman picture may have prompted that. So all the yellow things. Oh, this is when I started playing Crossy Road. I was so obsessed with it. This game, okay, I'm gonna read to you what I wrote here. This game is frustrating, fun, makes me scream. My inner sailor comes out. It's addicting and cute. My husband said, this is like my Pokemon. I heart Pokemon. I was playing this game while in line at the grocery store and I burst out laughing when I got the flea character. In here. Yep, I'm that person that counts down to Christmas even though it's like over a month away. And This picture, I love this picture because it reminds me of one of my favorite characters on TV, Mrs. Slocum from Are You Being Served? Super old British show that I grew up watching. My family doesn't watch that show. It was just my weird thing that I liked to watch when I was a kid. And I probably shouldn't have been watching it. But to this day, I still love watching it. And I put the date this time on this pencil cutout. Lots of drawings and cutouts. I made a little to-do list for myself at the bottom there. And what did I talk about? Oh, husband going back to work from vacation and video games. Here I was complaining about this glue stick that I was using that I do not like. I don't know why I drew it. There's just some cutouts on this page. And Baymax. Oh, and Sadie did a barrel roll. It wasn't so cold today, but everything had a layer of ice on it this morning. When I took Sadie out for her bathroom break, she went barreling out. Her paw slid all over, and it made me think of Bambi after he was born. She didn't even care. She was rolling all over the place and having a blast. Oh my gosh, I just wrote something funny. Okay, at the bottom, you'll see two hands. Okay, it says here, so my husband has been somehow hiding the fact that he lost one of his mitts. He's been using one and alternating hands as needed. Guy things. I completely forgot about that. Oh my gosh. Oh, that just made me laugh. That was awesome. Okay. I need to bug him about that now. Seriously, that's so him. Oh my goodness. So as you see this page, there's marker. On this side, I kind of covered it up and just did stickers and some scrap paper doodles there. See, I remember using this paper, like, it was like a long pad of paper from Target. So I would like start making a list on it, and when I'd finished, I'd have the rest of the page left over. So I'd end up using it in here or leaving notes. So yeah, I would use this, the rest of it, as decoration in here or in my planner. I did a little doodle all bundled up because it was freezing cold. And it says, I have the heater turned up high and so far nobody's noticed. And I have drawings and stuff. All red and white now. Getting festive. On this side there's just scrapbook paper. Maybe it's, well, I guess for fun because there's no marker on the other side. A quote on the label. And then different cutouts and things, and stickers and doodles. Oh, this cute little snowman there. So my date stamp looks, it says here, I dropped my stamp. So you can see that there's, you can see where it fell on the page. I do that at least once a week to this day. So there's marker on this side. So the opposite side of the page, I have a piece of, feels like sketchbook paper with a quote. And this day looks like an orange day, so there is a cutout of a cat with its back turned. And just different bits that I've saved inside of these. There's different things, stickers. These weird paper tape things I found at Target. I bought it when I went to the States. Oh, I have them right here actually. You guys probably have seen these. So I bought these that year, so 2014. It's these things. There's, it comes in a whole pack. There's one, two, I can't pull them out of the container. Yeah, there's six colors, so it's like basically the rainbow. And maybe I read the packaging wrong, but I was super excited because this was like back when washi tape was really scarce. And I saw this pack when I was in the States, got super excited, and I'm like, oh my god, it's that washi tape. And yeah, it's actually just, it's like cardboard paper with like adhesive on the other side. So I didn't use it a lot in my journal, but I use this in my planner to mark, like to highlight special days or like specific dates. Anyways, back to the journal. Looks like I have another headache. Oh yeah, so there's stamps on top of those paper tape strips, like earth tones, greens and beiges. This is from packaging of a bookmark that I bought. And this side has a quote. It says, "Do you understand? All you can do in this life is follow your dreams. Otherwise, you're just wasting your time." And that was from David Walliam's book called Gangsta Granny, which was one of the books I'm currently reading. It's hilarious and sweet. It is a sweet book. It's really funny. Ooh, this is when we went to go see the Dolly exhibit. So on this side I have, this is the Winnipeg Art Gallery. So when you drive, like when the Dolly exhibit was there, you drove by and there's this ginormous picture of him. This is his painting. They had this on the wall. It was so big. It's the Santiago El Grande. He also designed jewelry. So there's earrings that he made there. These are all from the brochure that came for free. There's more cutouts here. A map of the inside of the gallery, of one of the floors. And then that same day, I had lobster tail and crab legs for the first time. My siblings were with me and they were trying to teach me how to use the tools. It was my first time using these tools. It felt so awkward. It felt weird. Yeah, so I tried painting the crab legs and the lobster tail. There was lots of snow that day. Oh, there's more overflow because I have this here. This is from the newspaper and a newspaper advertisement of it. I cut this out of the newspaper long before I got to go to the exhibit. I was so excited. I'm very happy I got to see his work. Salvador Domingo Felipe Jacinto Dali y Domen... Oh my gosh, I cannot read that. I'm sorry. Dominic. Y Dominic. Don't quote me on that. I really don't know if that's how you pronounce it. Well, this is, receipts, parking stubs, a napkin from that restaurant where I took apart that seafood, and oh, we're at the end. So the last page here is just overflow of more stuff. Ooh, okay, so this is a chopsticks holder, this ombre green strip in the middle, and then this was a really cool moleskin postal notebook that I found while I was at the art gallery that I bought. I ended up filling up the notebook and giving it to my friend as a present for Christmas, part of his Christmas gift. So that's the end of this. Wow, that felt really nice going through this. So that may have been the longest flip through because I took my time and I just read bits here and there on each page. But I'm glad I did it that way because I was reminded of all the things that happened that month. I hope you guys enjoyed walking down memory lane with me. I had a fun time. So if you guys have any questions, comments, or anything like that, just leave it in the comments section below. And I'll talk to you guys later. Bye!